So I'm writing a blog right now, preparing for the step where it says I'm going to nose the first spirit to see if there is a difference. So it doesn't have any text yet, so let's see what happens. The first is a Broomsland Numic spirit. I hope the video makes it in the mirror, because otherwise you can't read it. And there's some pretty interesting stuff on the back. It's 7 days old, I think. 70%, it's very potent, and it's Olympus 2017. And the second sample is the rocks from another farmer, Daniel. The other one is called Mark from Wexford, and the other one is Daniel Delaney from Leiois. I'm not sure how to pronounce that. Both are 71%-ish, 71.35, 71.07, and they were distilled quite close to next to each other, 11.3.19 and 24.04.19. That's European months, days stuff. So days, month, years, not the other way around like they do in the USA. Both Olympus, I'm assuming the process is going to be the same for the Waterford distillery. I'm assuming the cuts were the same. That's an assumption. And I'm also assuming that they haven't been put in wood, because there is absolutely no color to these at all. So first, this is the Broomsland, and this is the rocks. And just, I said I would try these and see if there is a difference at all between these two. Let's see. Nothing sharp, that's good. Fruity. Oh. Clear difference. I won't try and say which tasting notes I get, because I'm terrible at these things, especially in Numic spirits. This is going to be boring, because I won't say anything and you will see me sniffing, but this is a little hint of coffee, and this is not. This one has some, normally when you have Numic spirits, there's a what I think is a banana note, which is typical for stuff that comes off the stills. I also tasted or nosed this at the Turf Exlo distillery in Holland, where I could taste together with another whiskey friend. The distillery burned down. It is very sad, and the owner perished in the flames, actually. But I was fortunate enough to taste the Numic spirit, and I recognized some of this Numic. And I had also had some Numic at Ardbeg, and it's nothing like that. It's another spirit. Well, okay, whoa. Jeez. That's potent. Glass. Some water, which you need. Much more syrupy. Okay. Sorry about the swirling noise, but it's best to cleanse your palate. That's different. I don't even think I will make notes of this because I'm going to post this video at the bottom of the blog. It should turn off. You have to take my word for this because this is same barley, same island, different place, and it tastes different. The problem with not tasting enough Numex is that my palate is, I'm going to put this away, my palate is used to spotting notes that have to do with mature whiskies, and since this is Numex, the connections in your brain don't draw on memories that identify with I've tasted this before, because honestly I haven't had too much new make, and the only one that I did have was through a sample of Highland Park, which I bought from via the Whiskey Fabric. I had some new make at this Turf Exlo, which it was totally different than this one, but it had a mash bill, not only barley, and I had some Ardbeg new make in 2016 when I was in Islay, and oh yeah, I had some new make from what's that called, the distillery in Chicago. But that's again different. I would love some Bruichladdich new make, by the way, but there's hoping. Anyway, to close Broomsland, this is herbal. This is banana. That's new make, same distilleries, same everything, I'm assuming. That's an assumption. I will see if I can ask Ned if the process was the same on these two spirits of mine. I'm assuming that they are. I will get some confirmation. But okay, my palate is getting used to 70%. less difference on the palate, but on the nose it's very clear. Yeah. I'm gonna press this button, and people that have watched my YouTube in the past have noticed that I don't edit my videos. I just don't care. It's for me to document what I'm doing. So I was doing this. Tasting these Numex spirits from Waterford. Thank you very much. And next up will be these, but I will save these till a later date because my palate is not totally screwed from the 70% ABV. Thank you guys at Waterford. Thanks, Ned. And thank you, Mark. Thank you. I will push the red button and hopefully we'll be back with another tasting. But this is one.